I suspect, looking at the weather, a new record is on.
We got boats as big as Banque Populaire, which is a 140-foot trimaran, that will probably do the race in 30 hours.
Banque Populaire V is the biggest racing trimaran in the world.
Come aboard perhaps the most extraordinary boat on the planet right now.
That's an amazing machine, you know, that's the Blue Beast.
I mean, it's an incredibly fast boat.
Even in France, we know the name like that. Fastnet Race is like, I don't know, that's really a reference.
The sheer power of this French machine is incredible. Yet it feels effortless, like being on a TGV, watching the world go by at sublime speeds. The crew of Banque Pop battle at the front with another French tri, Gitana.
So Gitana is just there. They already passed us, and we are going to pass them again, so that's nice.
Gitana are soon left for dust as Banque Pop enjoy a perfect English summer's eve.
Une petite tranche pour l'apéritif, s'il te plaît. Ça, c'est beau, ça. Oh là là, regarde ça. 5 étoiles, magnifique.
Là, quand il arrive amputé dans la cale, on jouait sur l'élasticité.
They say offshore races are won and lost at night.
Oh, il est là, c'est la nuit.
Yeah, happy to be back in with the team, to play with them, to share this fabulous moment.
It's upwind all the way to the rock in under a day.
Yeah, that's under 24 hours. It's 39 minutes to the 24 hour.
And it's always a pleasure to run the Fastnet. That's a rock. Et voilà, et là on accélère.
Downwind, Banque Pop takes off. Raw speed keeps the French team out of trouble.
In fact, the bad weather arrived just behind us, and I'm pretty sure it will be really tricky for the rest of the fleet.
With the end in sight, Banque Pop carves through the main fleet, all on their way out to the rock. Brian Thompson has 40 ocean multi-hull records to his name and explains a little of this extraordinary boat's magic.
Downwind, the boat and reaching, the boat can set unbelievable times. 900 miles in one day, you know, Atlantic in less than 4 days. There's no other boat really can do that. And I think it's a combination of the high-tech features like canting rig, foils in the outer hull, and then the very, very long, fine bows, which keep the boat from pitch bowling. So the sails are set really far back, but the bows go out a long way. So you, downwind, you can push the boat really, really hard.
Crossing the finish line in Plymouth, the crew set a new race record and the outright course record. 1 day, 8 hours, and 48 minutes. This could stand for a long time. Next for the crew is non-stop round the world and a target of 48 days or less. For now though, a little glory and reflected glory.
But now I'll have the double, the unlimited multi and the under 50. And incidentally, that was with you, Digby.
Yay! Woohoo! Put it there, man.
We'll do it again. So in fact, Digby, you're also a double Fastnet world record holder.
Oh, happy days.
Fantastic.
Thanks very much indeed.